Today I'm sharing 3 ways that you can get more video clients for your video production business without sounding spammy or appearing desperate. What's going on, videographer slash live streamer slash whoever you are? My name is Effin Moses Blacksburg. I'm the owner of ZMB Media, and I've been working professionally in the video world for over a decade now. Something that keeps coming up time and time again is the topic of landing new clients. I see people asking questions like, what's the best website for job postings? Or how do I find clients? To be honest, these 2 questions make me queasy. Because if I could explain how to do this in a simple Facebook comment or in a text message, I'd be way richer, and there would be thousands of people running around with DSLRs making 6 figures a year. It drives me nuts when I hear the buzzwords or phrases job posting website or find clients, because the way I've built my brand doesn't harness either of those things. For starters, if you rely on a job posting website like Upwork, Thumbtack, Craigslist, Fiverr, or even Production Hub, you are basically saying, hey, I want to be lazy about how I build relationships with people, and I want jobs to be fed to me on a silver platter. Now, if that insulted you, I'm sorry, and I'm not going to sugarcoat this video. But if you want to run a business, you must learn to be able to market yourself. You can't expect the phone to ring off the hook just because you bought a 6K camera, a set of Cinema Prime lenses, and another 10 grand worth of gear. It simply doesn't happen that way, and anyone that thinks they'll just buy a Red and the work will show up is fooling themselves. There's a zillion other DPs in New York, Atlanta, or LA that already own a Red. Those that rely on their gear to bring in the work will be sorely mistaken 6 months down the road, especially if they aren't in one of the main film cities I just mentioned. Job sites are also the fastest race to the bottom of the barrel. So when you compete on sites like Thumbtack, there will always be someone out there offering a lower price. Clients don't always know that you get what you pay for in this industry. The second piece to this is the notion of finding clients. I really despise using this term as well because it makes me think of Elmer Fudd walking around with his shotgun saying,
"Be very, very quiet. I'm hunting wabbits."
A client is not a piece of meat. It's not something to be hunted down and conquered. A client is a living, breathing human that works for a company or an organization, and they have a very specific goal in mind. They make decisions based on their emotions. If it's a principal of a school, maybe their goal is to make this year's graduation a memorable and accessible event by live streaming it to a world audience. If the client is a nonprofit that has a yearly gala, their goal might be to raise $100,000, and by having you there to film the event, you can create content that encourages more people to donate. Whatever the client is, they want an end result, and so we need to keep that in mind. We don't hunt people down who are looking for results. We want them to seek us out as the best possible solution to their problem or desire. Lesson number 1. It's all about visibility and staying top of mind. When the 17-year cicadas came out and were buzzing around everywhere, my car looked like a bug juice graveyard. I mean, driving out on the highway at 65 miles per hour just makes those things splatter everywhere. What was a 2-inch long bug is now an 8-inch long streak across my windshield. I needed a car wash bad, but I'm a busy guy and it's not my priority. My priority is running my business, so it had to be convenient to me. The price had to make sense, and I didn't want to go hunting for a good car wash. As it turns out, on my way home, there's a car wash on the main road that I always see, and there's easily 6 to 8 cars parked out front with people hand washing and detailing or vacuuming. The visibility is high, and it's this big green building with bold letters saying car wash on the side. You bet that's where I took my car. This isn't to say that I could have Googled car washes near me, and we're going to talk about that in lesson number 2, but at the end of the day, that visibility is what convinced me to go there without even bothering to search. So lesson number 1, visibility. Here's how you can do this too. For starters, as you grow as a business, you'll find that having a studio space to call your own and to have your logo on the front door will make a big difference. But for many beginners, that's not possible right away. So what can you do? You can post to social media. We are constantly posting behind the scenes photos and videos to our personal Facebook pages, our business page, LinkedIn, Instagram stories, you name it. We make sure that all of our friends and connections know exactly what we do on a daily basis. Lesson number 2. Optimization. This is very much in alignment with visibility in that this focuses on more of your online visibility. Let me preface this by saying you don't need a website to get started, but a website does help when it comes time to optimize. Remember back when I said I could go online and search for a car wash? It's not always my first step if there's already one that I know due to its high visibility. Now it's time to really dial in and make sure that when someone does go to their backup plan and start searching, that we are one of the first ones that pops up. Here are some quick and easy ways that you can do this too. For starters, you'll want a website where you are posting content on a regular basis. It could be a 300 to 400 word blog post that talks about a project that you worked on recently. Just make sure to use keywords people are searching for, such as videographer in Atlanta or video production studio in Oklahoma. The goal is to vary up the keywords in your content on all of your pages and in your blog posts. Google will start to notice these things. The second action that you can take is to sign up for a Google My Business page where you can get your location added to Google Maps. Add photos and as much information as you can to this listing. The third is to make sure your branding is consistent and recognizable across all platforms. I should be able to go to your YouTube channel where I see your logo and brand colors and then quickly hop over to your Instagram page and find a very similar look. For something like $20 to $30, you can get one on Fiverr and have a designer do this for you. It's really that easy. Pay the money to do it rather than waste 4 hours of your afternoon. You're not a graphic designer. Leave that job to those that do it on a daily basis. My last lesson for getting more clients is to share with you my mantra that has never failed me since starting my business, and that is do good work and treat people well. This means showing up on time, if not early, making sure that you appear well-rested and professional, calling clients to follow up with them instead of texting, always learning and advancing your craft. Find new ways to shoot for interactive content and look at what the experts are doing so you can emulate them. My super secret tip is anytime you finish a project with a new client, send them a thank you gift. If they spent $1,000 or more with you, you can spend $50 to $100 on them to let them know how much you appreciate their work. Ship them a box of brownies, or better yet, a custom branded swag item with your company logo on it that they might wear around town. People will remember how you made them feel, and if you make them feel like royalty, they're going to sing your praises from the rooftops. That alone could lead to hundreds of referrals over the next few years. So what's your method for landing new clients? What secret tips do you have that you can share with your fellow colleagues below in the comments section? Can you hit that like and subscribe button for me? And then let us know below what you think.